5 years I am doing Kundli, close to 5 years. I think I had a fantastic time doing Kundli, and people know me as Rishabh Luthra now. Wherever I go, people recognize me doing Rishabh Luthra. They don't recognize me as Mane, they recognize me as Rishabh. So I think I did something good, perhaps. That's the reason people love me. I received a lot of love through Kundli. I enjoyed being the part. I enjoyed the entire journey that I've had. I learned a lot. I unlearned a lot. I gathered a lot, received a lot. I gave a lot. But I think it was time to fly and do something better, and to sit on another branch and try something that makes me uncomfortable, because I know my character like a back of my hand, because a lot of Rishabh Luthra comes from Manit. I am like that in my real life a lot. There are other aspects also which I wanted to explore. So it was time, so I wanted to fly, and I was looking for something fresh, some more opportunities, and some very fantastic good work is going on web and TV and other things. So I wanted to be a part of all those wonderful projects. Yeah. I don't want to assume things. Perhaps someone will, or perhaps someone will not. But I personally, if I see somebody as a particular character, for me, it's a difficult thing to see someone else in that shoes. So, yeah, I don't want to assume things. Perhaps you have somebody better than me, and they can do that. They're very good actors out there. So, of course, you should never underestimate actors' talent. You know, of course they can do it. Of course they can do it. Ooh, dearest to my heart, it took everything away from me. Every single day when I used to do that show, I used to go back with a feeling. I used to, at the end of the day, after backup, I used to feel hollow and empty. I used to think that I've given every single thing that I had. But even then, I used to look forward to the next day. That's the magic of a good character. That's the magic of a good story. It was true. It was honest. It was not my character that I built. I'm not trying to show off, but I never took any reference from anybody. Some references from real life, from some references from real people that I have met. Yes, apart from that, I didn't watch any film or anything like that. In fact, I didn't have a lot of time to prepare for the character only. I used to do it on the go, and plus good characters doesn't come easy. And it came in my kitty. I'm very fortunate. A lot of people watched that show. And in fact, other day, a very dear friend who lives abroad, she texted me after a long time. She must have seen that on YouTube, and she just saw that and she texted me, and we touched base again. And she said, "My God, I got so hooked on to your series that she watched it in titles." She said, "I got so hooked on to series that I ended up watching all the episodes." She said, "I used to make sure after the work I at least watch 2 episodes. It was such a beautiful series. Why did it end?" Because it had to end. Yeah, so it was beautiful. I'm very fortunate that I did Prem Bandhan. I'm very fortunate, and I'm very I'm glad that it turned out to be the way it did. So it was beautiful. So, you know, because the character was like that, you know, it was emotionally draining, emotionally very demanding, physically very demanding. So I used to feel you know, if there is no fun, then we are going to go in that dark zone. I didn't want to go in that dark zone. At the end of the day, anything that resonates with you should have an entertaining factor also. At the end of the day, you are acting and you are entertaining people. That's your job. So I didn't want to make it too dark. But there were few scenes jahan pe aap thoda sa dark ho jaate ho. So one day, my co-actress, Chavi, so she was in the room downstairs. Hamara break tha. And I had some blood here. I was shooting for the scene, and she wasn't in the scene. And I was shooting in the scene where I had blood mark here and all of that. And I went, I knocked the door, and she didn't open the door. I just knocked it again. She didn't open the door. Perhaps she was inside in the washroom or something like that. She didn't hear the knock. And I told the production guy, and I held my hand like this. And I went, and she started banging the door. The moment she opened the door, she was sleeping inside. She switched on the light, and my God, there was a break. She was sleeping. And I held it. She said, "What happened? What happened?" And I said, "Oh my God, I got hurt. And she just, she freaked out. And there's now one production guy was already recording. I still have that recording in my phone. It was beautiful. So we had many moments like that. We used to enjoy a lot. And then during lockdown, we created the bubble. We went to Gujarat. We were putting up in a resort. We were shooting. We had some fantastic moments. A fantastic time shooting for that entire show. And she's afraid of water. She doesn't know how to swim. So when we were shooting for that sequence, she didn't know how to swim. It was a really Herculean task for her to come in swimming pool, where I just jump in the water and I save her. My God, it was a difficult task, very, very difficult task. So we just played it a lot with that. I mean, I tried pulling a leg and all of that. So yeah, it was fun. It was all together, you know, every single day we used to joke around the entire day. We had a fun director on set. We used to, you know, the show becomes memorable because you meet some good people, you know, good story, good character. You perform good and there's a good positive vibe on set. You all are on the same page. So that's when, you know, the show becomes beautiful. The show becomes memorable. All I want to say is thank you for giving me so much of love. You guys have been constant support. You guys have been backbone of my career. And I think without you, I am nothing. I do many things for you guys. So you guys have given me a lot of work. Hang on. I will be back something interesting for you guys. And I hope you like it. Thank you and take care of yourselves.